Welcome to another session on design animation elements. In today's session, we'll study how to design a single and multi-plate clutch. So we have to understand the design procedure for single and multi-plate clutch. We have studied the function of clutch, how it works in an automobile in the previous sessions. So this figure shows a schematic representation of a friction clutch. So the function of a clutch is to disengage the input shaft from the output shaft. In an automobile, the input shaft is connected to the crankshaft. So we have the crankshaft, that is the input shaft, and the output shaft is connected to the transmission or the gearbox. So when we have to disengage the power, we use a clutch in between. And in friction clutches, we use a friction material between the mating surfaces. When they are pressed together, we can transmit power, and during disengagement, they are moved apart. We have seen how to design for uniform wear and uniform pressure condition. For a just briefing, uniform pressure theory is applied for new clutches, whereas uniform wear theory is used for clutches in use. And this is the most commonly used one. Uniform wear theory is the most commonly used theory for the design of friction clutches. I will take a sample problem. Determine the power transmitted by a single plate clutch at 1200 RPM inside and outside dia. So we have a clutch plate, the outer dia, this is the outer dia, and this is the inner dia. Outer dia is given as 300 mm, and inner dia is given as 100 mm. So we'll write all these given details. Power equal to, determine the power transmitted. Speed n is given as 1200 RPM. Inside dia is 100 mm, outside dia is 300 mm, and coefficient of friction at the friction surface is 0.25, and permissible pressure equal to 0.06 MPa. 0.06 MPa in same as Newton per millimeter square. We have to find the power transmitted. It is given, we have to assume uniform pressure. So we can assume that it is a new clutch. So in this case, for uniform pressure theory is given in page 258 of the data book. These are the equations: axial force and the torque transmitted. So take the first equation, FAP equal to FAP, where FAP, A stands for axial and P for uniform pressure. So FAP equal to 1 by 4 pi P into dO square minus dI square, that is equation 13.9a. I can take that equation. So I will write that equation number, equation 13.9a. FA equal to 1 by 4 pi P into dO square minus dI square, where the values of pressure are known. Pressure equal to 0.06 MPa, 0.06 Newton per millimeter square. Further, outer dia is given. Outer dia equal to 300 mm, and inner dia is given as 100 mm. I can substitute these values. I will get axial force FA equal to 3769.91 Newton. After getting the axial force, I can get the torque. So if you get the torque, power equal to 2 pi n t by 60. So I will take the second equation for the torque. Torque equal to 1 by 2 mu n dash f a p d m p. That is equation 13.9 c. I can take that equation and can find the torque. So going to the next page. So torque transmitted, that is equation 13.9 c. okay, always write the equation number 13.9 c, page 258. T equal to 1 by 2 mu n dash f a into dm, where mu is given 0.25, n dash is the number of friction surface, for a single plate clutch. If nothing is mentioned, I can assume both sides have friction surfaces. So there are friction surfaces on both sides. So n dash is the number of friction surfaces. So n dash will be equal to 2 for single plate clutch. So assume both side effective. We had to write that. Assume friction lining on both sides, or I can rewrite as assume both side effective. Take n dash equal to 2. We have found the value of F A, that is 3769 Newton. And mean dia. What is mean dia? For uniform pressure theory, we have the mean dia equation. Mean diameter DMP equal to this big equation. So I can find DMP, that is a mean dia. I will rewrite that equation. So mean diameter DM equal to mean diameter DM equal to 2 by 3 into DO cube minus DI cube by DO square minus DI square. Outer die is 300 mm, inner die is 100 mm. I will get that value DM equal to, after substitution, 216.67 mm. So I can substitute that value also, 216.67 mm for uniform pressure theory. So I'll get the torque equal to 204 into 10 power 3 Newton millimeter. Now if we get the torque, we can find the power using the standard equation. Power equal to 2 pi n t by 60. So power equal to 2 pi n t by 60. Here n is given, n equal to 1200 rpm. In order to get the power in watts, I will substitute torque in Newton meter. Torque equal to 204 Newton meter. So I will substitute that value. I will get power equal to 25.6 into 10 power 3 watts. So this is the equation for this design for a single plate clutch. To find the dimension, all of these questions are very simple questions. We have to just substitute those values in the proper equations given in the data book. We will get those values. Now we have another question. A dry single plate clutch is to be designed for an automotive vehicle whose engine is rated to give 100 kilowatts at 2400 rpm, and in addition it is given maximum torque equal to 500 newton meter. So this is the maximum torque we had to transmit. So for all the design we should take the torque as a maximum value. For the outer radius is 25% greater than the inner radius. If the outer radius is denoted by RO and inner radius is RI, it is given RO equal to 25% higher. So I can write 1.25 RI. Pressure not to exceed 0.07 Newton per mm square. Friction value is 0.3. And the helical springs required by this clutch is to provide axial forces to engage the clutch are 8 in number. So there are 8 springs, and each of the spring has a stiffness of 40 Newton per mm. That is the stiffness of the spring. Determine the dimensions of the clutch and the initial compression in the springs. So we need to find the outer dia and the inner dia, and we need to find the initial compression. And as the second part, we need to find the dimensions of the spring, taking spring index equal to 6. Okay. So we'll write all those given data. So power equal to 100 kilowatts, speed n equal to 1200 rpm, and the maximum torque is given. Maximum torque is given as 500 newton meter. 500 newton meter equal to 500 into 10 power 3 newton millimeter. From the torque I can find all those other unknown values, and since it is given RO equal to 1.25 RI, I can write DO equal to 1.25 DI. Maximum pressure is given 0.07 newton per mm square, mu equal to 0.3. Now our first step is to design the spring, or we need to find the dimensions of the spring and the clutch. So first we will find the dimensions of the clutch. For that we can use maximum values of maximum torque. We can substitute in the uniform wear theory. So uniform wear theory is given in page 258 and 59. So torque equal to 1/2. This is our equation. Here I can take any of these two equations. So if we watch it closer, I can say that the second equation will yield the values more easier. I can get that value taking T equal to, I can write T equal to pi by 8 mu n dash p max. Okay. So in that equation, if I take that equation, mu equal to given as 0.3, it is given. N dash is the number of contact surfaces, friction surfaces. Assume both side effective, take n dash equal to 2. P max is the maximum pressure it can withstand, that is 0.07 newton per mm square. Here we have only two unknowns, DO and DI, and I can write DO equal to 1.25 DI. DO equal to 1.25 DI, which is the given value. So I can substitute all these values in this equation, and given torque equal to 500 newton meter. Torque equal to 500 into 10 power 3 newton millimeter. I will get the values of DI as 377.72 millimeter. Further, outer dia can be found as 472.16 mm. Sometimes it will be asked radial width of the friction surface. What is radial width? If the inner dia and outer dia is given, so DI is the inner dia, outer dia is DO. Radial width is this width B. So V equal to RO minus RI, we can find that value also, DO minus DI by 2, and this B is called radial width of the cluster. Now we can find the axial force in the clutch plate. So we have the equation axial force FAW. In the term FAW, A denotes axial and W denotes uniform wear. So our equation is 1 by 2 pi P max into DI into DO minus DI. You can take that equation 13.9D to find the axial force FAW equal to 1 by 2 pi P max. Here all the values are known. P max equal to 0.07 megapascal Newton per mm square. Further, DI is known, 377, we have found that value. DO equal to 472 mm. I can substitute that value and get FAW equal to 3857 Newton. This is the axial load on the clutch plate. Now we have to find the initial compression. When we apply the force, the spring will be compressed. So there is a spring. There is a spring. It is fixed at one end. When we apply the force, the spring will have a deflection x, and force is proportional to deflection, and I can write F equal to kx, where k is the stiffness and x is the deflection. I can write x equal to initial deflection, x equal to F by k, given each of the spring has a stiffness of 40 Newton per millimeter. Okay, and this load is shared by this load. What is the total load acting on the spring? Total load acting on the spring is 3857 Newton. That is this value. Okay, now in the question it is given the number of clutch springs equal to 8. So the total force is provided by 8 springs, or the force on one spring will be equal to force on one spring. Okay, I can write that total load equal to 3857 Newton provided by 8 springs. So load on one spring equal to, what will be that value? 3857 divided by 8, you will get that value as 482.12 Newton. If we know the force and the stiffness, this is the force acting on one spring, and stiffness of one spring equal to 40 Newton per millimeter, deflection will be equal to load by stiffness equal to load on one spring divided by stiffness equal to 12.05 mm. So by applying this load, 482 Newton, it will have a deformation of 12.05 mm. So this completes our first part. Now we have another part to this question. We have to find the dimensions of each spring. Assuming spring index equal to 6, allowable shear stress is 420 megapascal, G equal to 80 gigapascal, and this question can be considered to have a basics, to require a basics of deformation elements. One, in deformation elements, we have seen that spring index is denoted by C. Spring index is C. C equal to capital D by small d, where capital D is the mean dia and small d is the wire dia. Ratio of these values C equal to D by D is given as 6 in this case. Now, for the design of the spring, we need to know the force on one spring. We have found that value, force on one spring equal to 482.12 newton. Now we can first we'll find the diameter of the spring wire. So this is our equation, page 169, 11.1e. I can write d cube equal to 8f capital dk by pi tau. Here we have two unknowns, small d is known, capital D is also known. I can write capital D equal to small d into C or CD, or this equation will be equal to 8F into, instead of capital D I can write CD into K by pi into tau, where C equal to 6. If you get the value of C, I can substitute in equation 11.2A and I can get the value of k equal to 4c minus 1 by 4c minus 4 plus 0.615 by c, and after substituting c equal to 6 I will get k equal to 1.2525. so then force is known, so one of the C will get cancelled. Okay, so D square equal to, one of this D will can cancel out, so D square will be equal to, after substitution D square will be equal to 8F C K by pi into tau, where F is the load on one spring, that is 482.12 newton, C equal to 6, and substituting C equal to 6 I will get K equal to 1.2525. this is very easy to remember those values. Then maximum shear stress, tau is also given, tau is also given. Tau equal to 420 megapascal. After substitution I will get small d equal to 4.686 mm. After getting the diameter I can standardize that value. I will get the standard value from page 188, table 11.2. assume cold round wire unalloyed, the standard wire dia will be equal to 4.75 mm. Now in the following steps we have to substitute this standard dia for all the other calculations. Now we can find the active number of coils. Active number of coils are those which gets deformed under the application of load. So equation for I equal to, I'll write that equation, I equal to YGD by 8FC cube, where Y is the deflection. Deflection, we have found that value, deflection equal to 12.05 mm. G is the modulus of rigidity. Modulus of rigidity given as 80 gigapascal, 80 into 10 power 3 Newton per millimeter square for steel material. Small d is the diameter of the wire, 4.75 mm. F is the load, 482.12 newton, and C equal to 6. I will get number of turns I equal to 5.41 turns. Since I should be a whole number, I will take I equal to 6. So total number of turns, so there are 6 turns. In order to reduce stress at the ends, I will give 2 end coils. So these are the end coils at top and bottom. So there are 2 end coils. So total number of turns will be equal to, I will write the total number of turns as IT. IT equal to I plus 2 equal to 6 plus 2 equal to 8. Further, I can find the free length. The free length is the length of the spring when it is free of load. So ITD equal to free length is denoted by LO equal to IT into D plus 1.15 deflection. So 8 into diameter, the it is IT into D plus 1.15 into deflection, that is 12.05 mm equal to 51.85 mm. Now we can find the pitch also. Pitch is the distance between two consecutive spring coils. Pitch equal to free length by IT minus 1. Pitch equal to, we have another equation, pitch equal to free length by number of turns minus 1. So 51.85 divided by total number of coils 8 minus 1. Okay, we can find that value also. So 51.85 by 7 will give you 7.407. So this completes the design of spring also. Okay, so we are in this question. I'll give a recap of this question. It's a very simple question. We have done this question only in two or three pages, but it's a very simple question. So in this question, we are given power and RPM, and in addition we are given a maximum torque. So we use this 500 Newton meter for all the calculations. RI and RO was given. Further, we need to find the dimensions, for which I used this torque 500 Newton meter for the design. So our first step was to find the values of DI and DO, to find the dimensions of the clutch. I took the equation for the torque. Maximum torque was taken, 500 into 10^3 Newton mm, from which I got the value of DO and DI. Further, we have found the value of axial force. Axial force equal to 1 by 2 pi P DI into DO minus DI. Initial compression equal to force load by stiffness. Stiffness was given. Then we have found the dimensions of the spring. This completes our second question also. So when we have to design, when we get the problems from the clutch, sometimes we will have to design the springs also. Okay, this is an example for such a type of question. Now we can see what is a multiplate clutch. What will be the advantage of a multiplate clutch? There will be more amount number of friction surfaces. So more number of friction surfaces means it can transmit large amount of torque, and such multiplate clutches are used in large when we have to transmit larger amount of torque. Okay, so we will see how these multiplate clutches are designed. And number of contact surfaces, this should be, you have to remember in mind, number of contact surfaces n should always be an even number, because number of driving disc n1 equal to n/2 and driven disc n2 equal to n1 plus 1. This equation is not given in the data book. You have to memorize this equation, n1 equal to n/2 and n2 equal to n1 plus 1, where n1 is the number of driving disc and n is the number of friction surfaces or the contact surfaces. I will take a standard question. Design a multiplate clutch for a following specification. power equal to 25 kilowatts, 1400 RPM. Power is given, mu is given, mu equal 0.2. Maximum minimum dia, there is outer dia and the inner dia are given, 0.3 meter and 0.1 meter. Pressure between the contact surface is 0.08 megapascal. Find the axial force required. Okay, find the axial force, then number of friction surface, number of disc on driving and driven shaft. Okay, there are four, no, okay, six springs and each, okay, we will see one by one. First we will find the axial force required. So for that, first we will write what are the given details. Given power equal to 25 kilowatts equal to 25 into 10 power 6 newton millimeter per second. Speed n equal to 1400 rpm. If in any question power and rpm is given, we can find the torque. Torque equal to 60 p by 2 pi n. Substituting power and rpm, I will get the torque equal to 170.5 into 10 power 3 newton millimeter. Then given inside dia is 100 mm, minimum diameter 100 mm, and maximum dia is the outer dia equal to 0.3 meter equal to 300 mm, mu equal to 0.2, for the pressure equal to 0.08 megapascal, 0.08 newton per millimeter square. Now we can substitute all these values in the equation for axial force. For we can assume uniform wear theory. From uniform wear theory, if nothing is mentioned about whether it is uniform pressure or uniform wear, always assume uniform wear theory. So from equation 13.9d, Fa equal to, we take this equation again, write Fa as such, no need to write FAW. So I can write Fa equal to 1 by 2 pi P max into DI into DO minus DA. I will write that equation, 1 by 2 pi P max into DI into DO minus DI. All these values are known. DI equal to 100 mm, DO equal to 300 mm. Maximum pressure is 0.08 megapascal, 0.08 newton per millimeter square. I will get the axial force. Axial force Fa equal to 2513.27 newton. This is the maximum axial force it can stand to transmit this power. Now we can find the number of friction surfaces. Here we can see that number of friction surfaces comes in the equation for the torque equation. It's a multiplate clutch, so I can use the second equation, 13.9 F. So torque equal to 1 by 2 mu n dash, instead of FAW I will write FA itself, FA into DM. Here mu equal to 0.2, it is given. N dash is the friction surfaces, we have to find that value. Axial force equal to, we have found that value, 2513 newton. And DM is the mean dia. For uniform wear theory, mean dia equal to DO plus DI by 2. Mean dia DO plus DI by 2 equal to 300 plus 100 by 2 equal to 200 mm. And we have found that torque equal to 170.5 into 10 power 3 newton millimeter. I will get N dash. After substitution, I will get N dash equal to 3.39. So I will take the next even number, N equal to 4. N or N dash both are same. So N equal to 4 number of contact surfaces. N should always be a even number because number of driving disc N1 equal to N by 2. N1 equal to N by 2. Only if it is an even number, N1 will be a whole number. So N1 equal to 4 by 2 equal to 2, and driven disk equal to n1 plus 1, so 2 plus 1 equal to 3. This completes the design of the clutch. Now, as a second part, it is given, we have to consider another thing. There are 6 springs, each of stiffness 15 kilonewton per meter, and each of the contact surface as worn away by 1.5 mm. Find the maximum power that can be transmitted assuming uniform wear. This is a practical question. In this part of the question, we have to consider the wear of the clutch during the surface, and of course due to the wear of the clutch there will be lesser amount of power transmitted. We have to find the power that can be transmitted after wear. So take this figure. You see this figure. This shows a pair of contact surfaces, driving and driven contact surfaces, driving and the driven disc. We have four such pairs. It is given that we have four pairs of contact surfaces, because from the equations we have found that so we have four pairs of contact surfaces. Now we'll see one of those contact surfaces in which there is a driving disc and driven disc, and it is given that each of the contact surface has worn away by 1.5 mm. So at the contact surface there will be wear on driving disc as well as the driven disc. This is the worn part on each of these. So if I draw an enlarged view on the driving disc, there is wear up to a depth of 1.5 mm. Similarly, on the driven disc also, at the contact surface, there is a similar wear. This is the condition. So we have total pair of contact surface equal to 4. Total pair of contact surface. So the total number of contact surface will be equal to, so for one pair there will be two surfaces over which there is wear. So total number of contact surface will be 4 multiplied by 2 equal to 8 surfaces, and wear in one surface is 1.5 mm. So the total wear in 8 contact surface will be equal to, total wear will be equal, for one pair we have 3 mm of total wear, so we have 4 pairs, so total wear will be equal to number of contact surface 8 multiplied by wear in one contact surface is 1.5 equal to 12 mm. So what happens is that due to this wear, the spring compression will reduce by a total of 12 mm. So we have the springs. When it have a deflection of 12 mm, what will be the force corresponding to this deflection? Deflection will be equal to stiffness multiplied by deflection. Stiffness multiplied by deflection, that is deflection in total deflection is not 10 mm, it is 12 mm. Force corresponding to the deflection of 12 mm equal to stiffness multiplied by, and stiffness equal to, since all these springs are arranged in parallel, I can write stiffness equal to 15 into 6, that is 90 mm. So the total force F will be equal to due to this where the force which is reduced in the spring equal to stiffness 90 multiplied by 12 equal to 1080 Newton. What was the initial axial force? Initial axial force before where we have found that value from the previous steps, we have found that value equal to 2513 Newton from the first step. So after where the net force will be reduced, the compression the springs will be reduced, so the spring force will be reduced, so the net force will be equal to 2513 minus 1080 equal to 1433 Newton. Now we have to find what is the power transmitted after where. If we know the force, torque transmitted will be equal to, I can write the torque equal to 1 by 2 mu n dash Fa into dm, where mu is given as 0.2. What is the number of contact surface? N equal to, or n dash equal to 4. The new value of Fa will be equal to, after the wear out, the new value of Fa equal to 1433, and dm remains the same, equal to DO plus DA by 2 equal to 200 mm. I will get torque equal to 114.64 into 10 power 3 Newton millimeter. After getting the torque, I can find the power. Power equal to 2 pi nt by 60. Where n equal to speed, that is 1400 rpm, and t is the torque. I can substitute in Newton meter, so 114.64 Newton meter. So I'll get the power equal to 16.8 kilowatts. So this is the torque which can be transmitted after where. What is the initial torque? What was the initial power it was able to transmit before where? Okay, we'll see from the question. Initially, the power transmitted was equal to 25 kilowatts. After where, the compression in the springs has reduced the force on the springs, due to which it can transmit only 16.8 kilowatts. Okay, so I'll do a recap of this question. We have found the axial force. We have found the axial force from the equation Fa equal to 1 by 2 pi p into dA into dO minus dA. All those values were known. We have found the value of 2513.27 Newton. Now we have to find the number of friction surface. N equal to, we have found the N in the torque equation, so we have substituted the value of torque and we have got the value of N. And after finding the value of N, it should be remembered that N should always be a even number. So we have found the value of N also, N equal to 4. Number of driving shaft equal to number of disc on the driving shaft, N1 equal to N by 2. And number of disc on the driven shaft will be equal to disc on the driving and driven shaft, driven shaft N2 equal to N1 plus 1. So we have found that there are 4 pairs of contact surfaces. Four pairs means there are 8 surfaces, and each of these surfaces has a wear of 1.5 mm. So the total wear will be about 12 mm, and this wear of 12 mm will reduce the force acting on the spring. So the new force will be equal to stiffness multiplied by deflection. Since there are 6 springs, the total K will be equal to stiffness K equal to, this is the stiffness K equal to 15 multiplied by 6, that is 90 Newton per mm. We have taken this value as the stiffness, total stiffness multiplied by the deflection, we have got this force. So this is the force which was reduced in the spring due to wear. So the no So the net force after wear will be equal to initial force minus the difference, minus the reduction in force due to wear. So the two new force will be only 1433 newton, and after substituting that value we can find the new value of torque and get the power. Okay, this completes the design of single and multiplate clutch. If you have any doubts, you can contact. Okay, thank you.